Hey there, I'm Grindhouse Guy. Maybe you've seen the previous incarnation of this show, Grindhouse of Horrors. Well, that show and this show are pretty much about the same thing. Low-budget, exploitation cinema. Today we're going to look at a film that was pretty infamous in its day for the level of violence and gore. It's called Mark of the Devil. The film is a depiction of a time in history where witches were thought of like this, rather than like this. The film opens with music that is way too cheery and upbeat for what's actually happening in the film. Listen. This pretty tune plays over a scene in which nuns are sexually assaulted. Catholic guilt. It never goes away, does it?
In the name of the Lord, have mercy! Ah!
This movie doesn't fuck around. It gets right to the violence. The opening scene is a public execution of a few people accused of witchcraft. This is an exploitation film if there ever was one. Most movies would use the opening scene for character or story exposition. This movie uses it for violence exposition. It sets the tone by saying, yeah, there are characters and somewhat of a story, but this is essentially just torture porn.
I am albino.
We see that the local witch finder is nothing but a corrupt, perverted asshole who's only out for himself. Then we meet Christian, played by popular cult actor Udo Kier. He's a witch hunter in service to Lord Cumberland, who's come to the village to make sure things are being done the right way with regard to witch hunting. Bad news for the local witchfinder. Okay, while this guy might be one of the most unfortunate-looking men in the history of movies and perhaps even mankind, why the fuck is he called albino? He's not an albino! Christian demands to see all the paperwork about the witch trials in the village. Of course, albino has none because he's just a corrupt, perverted asshole. Which is made even clearer when he becomes enamored with Vanessa, a local tavern girl. When it turns out she's not interested in special private naked time with albino, he publicly accuses her of witchcraft and has her arrested.
I'm not a witch! I'm not a witch! I tell you, I'm not a witch! And you all know that!
Do you hear? She doesn't scream. She doesn't feel pain. Turn her around. She is a witch.
So wait, if she doesn't scream in pain, she's a witch. She just screamed in pain. So by your twisted logic, doesn't that mean she's not a witch? Christian believes Vanessa is innocent and has her freed. He clearly has quite the chubby for her as well. So instead of condemning her to torture, they have a lovely dinner and she spends the night in the castle.
Here. I hope you like the room.
And where's yours?
It lies exactly under this.
Please. What is your name?
Christian.
Sleep well, Christian.
Thank you.
You went home with the guy. You ate with him. You're about to spend the night in his house. And you just now asked him his name. She might not be a witch, but she's sketchy at the very least. But that doesn't stop them from becoming an item. So Lord Cumberland arrives to oversee all the local witch hunting activities. Although this guy turns out to be the villain of the film, at first he seems like a pretty reasonable guy.
You're free.
Thank you.
Next.
But then we find out he's pretty much just fucked in the head. So there's this young baron they say is possessed by the devil, when in reality the church just wants to take all his money. So they denounce him and throw him in the dungeon.
There's no doubt he's possessed. It'll mean the usual torture and interrogation until he's free of this devil.
Talks about torture like it's a fucking treatment. Here, take two of these and call me in the morning. And then the torture porn really begins. Every piece of sadistic gadgetry you've ever seen on display at your local Renaissance fair is present and accounted for. This movie was so violent, some marketing genius came up with the idea of releasing official Mark of the Devil vomit bags. Yeah, in case the over-the-top gore made you sick. That's got to be one of the most awesomely stupid gimmicks I've ever seen. And guess what? I have, not one, not two, but three of them. Yeah, and these aren't reproductions. These are the real fucking deal. I am holding three 40-year-old vomit bags. The fuck is wrong with me? At least they're unused. Albino finds out Cumberland is just in it for the money and tries to get in on it. But unfortunately for him, he uses the wrong word to threaten him with.
You burn innocent people, that you kill for money, that you're impotent!
Seriously, there seems to be this fixation on impotence throughout the movie.
Ever since then, impotence has fallen in our city so that men and women are not able to fulfill their marital duties.
Kissed him to bring impotence to the country.
Putting a curse on the region, making the men impotent.
I hope somebody spiked that wine with Viagra because we got a village full of limp dicks here. So a bunch of the witch hunters follow these kids back to a house where their parents are putting on a puppet show. The witch hunters mistake it for black magic and arrest everyone. Were people really ever this stupid? What the fuck am I saying? People are this stupid now. By the way, Vanessa's back in the dungeon, once again accused of being a witch. I wonder why.
Sometimes I wish I could bewitch you. Come here.
If you don't want to be locked up for witchcraft in a village fucking obsessed with witches, don't say shit like that. Christian begins to see Cumberland is really evil and once again sets Vanessa free. He goes back to free the Baron, but Cumberland captures him and locks him up with everyone else. Vanessa returns to the tavern and incites everyone to riot and rebel.
Hi, Barry boy!
Have fun storming the castle!
Don't get
away! Goodbye!
So the villagers revolt, kill all the guards, loot the place, and chase after Cumberland, who is apparently a gigantic idiot because he just threw away his only weapon to kill one guy. Okay, seriously, first he was Vader, now he's Batman. So the villagers free Christian, only to beat the crap out of him and drag him off to be executed. Why? Isn't he the good guy? They string him up on this post and... wow, that looks potentially painful.
Epic. Epic. Do you hear? That is the sound of ultimate suffering. My heart made that sound when Rivas wrote over my father.
So let me get this straight. The hero of the movie dies while the villain gets away scot-free? This isn't a bad movie, and the production quality is actually fairly good for what's essentially an exploitation film, but the ending just blows. I realize horror movies rarely have a happily ever after kind of ending, but Cumberland should have at least gotten killed, if not tortured, by his own damn sadistic toys. Anyway, I'm Grindhouse Guy, and that's Mark of the Devil, such as it is. 40-year-old vomit bags!